You're watching Unreal Ant Gaming. This is Gohan from Dragon Ball Z. You want to see me turn Super Saiyan? Or should I take it to the next level? I'm also the narrator, too. Next time on Dragon Ball Z, make sure and smash subscribe to Unreal Ant Gaming.
As 2020 nears its end, Super Dragon Ball Heroes continues to deliver content non-stop to fill the void of the missing Dragon Ball Super anime, but even as we near the beginning of a new year, Super Dragon Ball Heroes couldn't help itself but to continue to tease the future. However, is the future promising? As I do want to go on ahead and welcome you all to my Super Dragon Ball Heroes special episode anime review, to where this episode was shockingly enough featuring beats and notes from the original Dragon Ball Heroes promotional video game and anime, and this episode was strikingly interesting only because you had the fan favorites of pairing off specific characters in battling, in which a lot of the fandom had been curious about for such a long time, as even though the Super Dragon Ball Heroes promotional anime is very questionable in and of itself, as we near the end of 2020 and we near the beginning of 2021, there is, at least for Super Dragon Ball Heroes, a lot to look forward to. As once again, if of course you guys are new to the channel and want to be kept up to date with everything involving Dragon Ball, then I do encourage you guys to go on ahead and smash that subscribe button and turn on all notifications to never miss a single upload video on the channel, as well as giving this video a big thumbs up by slapping that like button down below. If you guys are simply stoked, ready, and excited to see what's going to come from this, because from the beginning of this episode, we get to see how Beat is trying to make his way into the mall, because this is the 10-year anniversary championship going down right now, and of course, he is one of the key players within this tournament, and he doesn't want to miss out, so the players should gather up on the second floor, and as Beats does, he ultimately winds up getting there, and his opponent is none other than Note. So as soon as Note and Beat actually lay down their cards, it's interesting because I'm getting Yu-Gi-Oh vibes, but at the same time, I have to keep in mind that these concepts in Super Dragon Ball Heroes are just that, right? Concepts. So what I found to be fascinating was we get to see how each of them lay down their set of cards on the field, and as soon as they get within the field, we then get to see how we have Super Saiyan Blue Beat and Super Saiyan Blue Note having to use their warriors, which of course we had Beat, who had the assembly of Super Saiyan Blue Vegito, Yamcha, Super Saiyan God Zeno Trunks, he had Capsule Corp UI Goku, Bardock, and Jiren, which Note on the other hand had Timebreaker Bardock, Super Saiyan Blue Gogeta, Dragon Ball Z Broly, Zeno King Vegeta, Final Form Demigra, and the Grand Priest. So as soon as they lay it down from the beginning, I absolutely love how for the first time, we see how it's Vegito Blue versus Gogeta Blue, and the second they throw down, it kind of makes you wonder so many things as to whether or not these concepts are possible in Dragon Ball Super, and you have to give Super Dragon Ball Heroes credit because Super Dragon Ball Heroes can really come up with some interesting kind of dynamics or concepts behind its story. For example, actually now being able to pair off and giving us Gogeta versus Vegito, even though the circumstance is through a card game, it's still interesting to see only because they actually threw down and they were destroying everything. And what's even more interesting was at first it kind of looked as if they were fighting evenly, because even as they were destroying everything until Bardock tried to get involved, in which Zeno Bardock stepped in, and then we had Zeno Bardock versus Timebreaker Bardock. So of course, Bardock versus Bardock, which of course was really cool to see, but what's even more fascinating than seeing two Bardocks go at it, which of course they are fan favorite characters, was seeing how it was the pairing off of the Bardocks and the fusions, but then Dragon Ball Z's Broly, which of course Ben Shimada did a great job in voicing him, he started powering up, right? And as soon as he started powering up, Beats was shook. But that's when Zeno Super Saiyan God Trunks stepped in, he pulled out his sword, and then he created this sphere that spawned the Supreme Kai of Time, and what she was able to do was she was able to momentarily stop time in preventing Broly from moving, in preventing Broly from powering up, and that's when Super Saiyan God Trunks took advantage by quickly stepping in and doing what he did in order to gain leverage over Broly, because as soon as Trunks was attacking him, once the time clock basically ran out, Broly was sent flying out into the distance. So all the while, Timebreaker Zeno King Vegeta actually went along to power up, and as he did, it gave Note the opportunity to have these little crystals to which the Grand Priest even told her to activate. So as soon as she goes up to activate these crystals, out of nowhere, Gogeta is the first person to step forward in unleashing these Ki Blasts at Bean, to unleash these Ki Blasts at Vegito. So as soon as this happens, surprisingly enough, Yamcha is there to heal Vegito and to heal Beat. So Yamcha actually did play a role in this by actually serving the purpose of being a supportive character. So this is heavily reminiscent to the game, just because this was a complete simulation of the game itself, with Beat and Vegito then having to unleash a Kamehameha directly at Note, and this took Note out quickly, because from there, as soon as it registered as it being an actual win, out of nowhere, that's when we get to see a new challenger step forward, and it's none other than the Gods of Destruction, Belmont, Champa, and these little kind of God of Destruction avatar figures, which again, they don't really have any names, they don't really have any stances, I would say, but either way, Beerus was attacking Beat, and we get to see how his little protege was. So again, Super Dragon Ball Heroes has such great concepts behind them. It's just very unfortunate that the Super Dragon Ball Heroes promotional anime is simply trash and will be nothing other than trash outside of Dragon Ball Super's anime, because comparing animes, the Super Dragon Ball Heroes anime is going to be absolutely subpar to Dragon Ball Super, which is why it's very unfortunate that we don't have a Dragon Ball Super anime. And we can look at Super Dragon Ball Heroes kind of like a big what if, or kind of like a big animated fan manga concept, because that's exactly where this came from, right? This is a fan manga-esque kind of concept, because nowhere else are you going to find Vegito versus Gogeta, Bardock versus Bardock, God Trunks versus Z Trunks. So as soon as Beat ends up going down to Beerus, Beerus's little avatar protege creates this massive sphere of destruction in the sky, and the only other person that can help Beat out at this point is none other than Capsule Corp Goku, right? Big surprise there, right? So as soon as the avatar launches this massive sphere of destruction from the sky, very similar to what we've seen go down during the Tournament of Power with Jiren and Goku, as soon as this blast actually makes contact with the Earth, all of a sudden, the blast is gone. And then from there, we get to also observe how Beat was actually able to activate the powers of Ultra Instinct in stopping the blast, but on top of Beat doing it, it wasn't just Beat, it was Goku as well. So the episode basically closes off with UI Omen Sign Goku and UI Omen Sign Beat standing in front of Hylas, Beerus, Champa, and of course Belmont, and their avatars, as of course they blitz right through. The promotional anime then comes to a close by setting the narrative that it's going to be Ultra Instinct Sign versus the gods and of course their avatars, which we've seen the evolution of Beat over the years. We've seen him obtain Super Saiyan 3, Super Saiyan God, Super Saiyan Blue, now UI Omen. Eventually he's going to master Ultra Instinct, so it's kind of no surprise there, but of course the story is going to continue. And even though we didn't get to see anything from characters like Dragon Ball Super Broly, we didn't get to see much of Jiren, I'm pretty sure we are down the line. However, there's also going to be an additional add-on to Super Dragon Ball Heroes Big Bang Mission number 6, and that is going to be another Limit Breaker character. Now, we don't know who this is. The outlier of this character does resemble that of Broly, so I'm fairly certain that at some point we are going to see a limit-breaking Broly be introduced in Super Dragon Ball Heroes, only because his silhouette, eerily enough, has a striking resemblance to Broly. So by the end of all of this, this episode really wasn't much. I was only excited just to see the fusions fight, to see Bardock fight, to see God Trunks actually involved with the original Dragon Ball Z Broly, and this kind of makes you wonder, again, as to what they have lined up in the future, as to what they could actually do with the Super Dragon Ball Heroes property, only because now they are starting to introduce concepts and characters that are really wacky. And even though I really doubt we're ever going to see this in Dragon Ball Super, I really hope that the people behind Dragon Ball Super get to see some of these concepts and ideas be adapted from Super Dragon Ball Heroes, like for example Gogeta versus Vegito, even having something involving Demigra, stuff like that, right? And hopefully enough they can incorporate that within Dragon Ball Super, and it's only a matter of time, because you guys already know it's coming, it's only a matter of time before they add Moro in Super Dragon Ball Heroes and other concepts and characters like that. So to give you guys a quick little update, the series that is of the Super Dragon Ball Heroes promotional anime is going to be continuing going into 2021. So does that mean that we're going to be getting another extended look of Hearts and other villains? Perhaps, maybe, because so far we know that Hearts is alive. We've seen him alive in the Super Dragon Ball Heroes promotional anime, but nothing much was shown of it. So are they going to save him for 2021? Are we going to get a different villain in 2021? We're going to have to wait and see. So again, thank you all so much for watching. Thank you all so much for your time. I want to get your thoughts in the comment section below about these concepts, about what, of course, Super Dragon Ball Heroes can do going into 2021. And I want to get your overall thoughts as to whether or not they should adapt specific concepts from Heroes and add that into Super, because I was really enjoying the fact that we got to see Fusion versus Fusion only until I saw that it was Super Dragon Ball Heroes. So again, thank you all so much for watching. Thank you all so much for your time. Be sure to give this video a big fat thumbs up if you guys enjoyed. Also, smash that subscribe button if you guys are new. Tune back in for more, and I'll be seeing each and every single one of you guys down in the comment section below. Have a great day, everybody, and take care. Peace. And a quick little reminder before you guys go, if you guys are unaware, I do have a second gaming channel located down in the description box below, so be sure to head on over to Unreal Royale and hit that subscribe button along with turning on all notifications, as to there, you guys will find all different kinds of gaming content that you will not get to find on Unreal and Gaming, titles and video games such as Grand Theft Auto, Call of Duty, Gears of War, Dragon Ball Z Dokkan Battle, Dragon Ball Z Legends, Dragon Ball Z Budokai Tenkaichi IG3, Minecraft, Blair Witch, and many other retro games on that channel. So if you guys are into gaming, then make sure you guys subscribe over on Unreal Royale. I want to thank you all so much for your time, and I'll catch you all in the next one.
This is the Galactic Emperor of the Universe, and of course I'm here to tell you to subscribe to Unrelent Gaming.
Also follow Unrelent Gaming on these social media platforms to stay connected at all times. And if you don't, then very soon you will all be dead! Oh, did someone say Unrelent Gaming? Oh my god.
The fuck, Zarbon? Put on some clothes!
Well, why don't you put on any clothes?
What? I don't need clothes, but Jesus Christ, that's huge! What, Broly?
Freezer.
Uh-oh.
Prepare to die!
Boo, I'm a real gaming! Boo wants you to get video all lots of likes, or Boo will turn you into chocolate!
Vados, get over here! Tell these mortals that I'm the biggest Unreal Engine Gaming fan. This is my moment. I'm a part of his notification squad. Universe 7 can have all the fun. I just want the food.
And don't forget to leave a comment on this video. Show some love for the best community on YouTube.
Kakarot!